Well, I built a secret road bike, and if you follow me on Instagram, you've seen shots of this, but I've never put it on the channel till right now. So let's talk about my aluminum disc, non-internally routed bike frame that I bought, and why I bought it, and to see if maybe this will help you on your next decision to buy a road bike or any other kind of bike, to be honest. So let's get into my secret road bike build. So let me give you some backstory so you understand why I went this route, so you can kind of see my thought process on building this bike, especially in 2023, which is what I did. But as something that's viable now. Now, a big thing that I was looking for was a new road bike build because I was previously working at a Trek dealer and I was managing it. And so because of just old school me, since I've been in bike shops over the years here and there, you always eventually want to buy a frame or a complete bike in the brand that you sell if you want to stay long term. And that's why they give you a great incentive for employee discounts, especially if you want to go on a group ride. You don't want to be selling Treks and then riding and who knows what else. So I went through the same thing because I was working on hopefully getting a group ride back together. So that led me down the path of, okay, I want a road bike from Trek. I was happy with my other builds currently, and that was the one that I was like, okay, this makes sense. I have basically a complete bike. I could just put it on a new frame set. What do I get? Now, I was looking at the Amanda mainly because I still do prefer a lightweight, more agile bike if I'm going road than the Del Monte, which is more endurance. Realistically, that's probably a better frame set for my now physicality riding style and position, but we all have aspirational dreams. So that being said, I looked at both the frame sets alone, the aluminum and the carbon. And originally why I wanted to go with that was because of Rides of Japan, because of his beautiful super weight weenie SLR frame from Trek, and in the colorway that I wanted as well. But those frames, even with my discount, are crazy expensive. Now they are extremely lightweight, but that was way out of budget. Then I looked at the regular SL frame set, which is the same geometry and everything, but a heavier carbon layup. And then I looked at the aluminum version. Now, the benefit to going to the aluminum one was it was slightly higher stack in the front end, so it'd be a little bit more comfortable, and weight-wise, it was, like, surprisingly close. So, like, this is crazy. It can't be that close. I know Trek makes great aluminum bikes, and not all aluminum bikes are created equal. Don't get me wrong. They do make some of the best aluminum frames, in my opinion. Specialized LA is a great frame set as well. There's other brands that do aluminum well, and some that don't do it well. But that being said, I was like, all right, well, let me see if I can find a similar spec bike. So I found the 105 mechanical spec bike in both the aluminum version and the carbon version. And Trek is one of the few companies that actually lists the weight for the complete bike in a size 56, which is what I ride. And I scrolled all the way down and looked at, again, the aluminum weight versus the carbon weight. Scary close. And it's only slightly heavier than the carbon version, which obviously is going to be about $1,000 more. And if you look at the spec sheet, yeah, it's the exact same bike. It's the exact same wheels, tires, and group set. So this is a pretty much apples to apples comparison, and the Amanda has a integrated carbon seat mast where you have a traditional seat post on the ALR. So that being said, I was like, well, why wouldn't I go with the aluminum frame? Now, I didn't like the colors of the two options. This is a shot of it. I had the gray to black, if I can find it. And so I repainted it in this beautiful custom paint job. This is essentially like a color flip galaxy effect that I put on. I don't have any footage of it, unfortunately. And then I did some hand stencil for the Trek logo and the splatter and hand laid some gold leaf on it and matched the stem to go with the look. And I think it turned out beautiful. I love the gold accents with these Vittoria tires. I think as a package, it looks incredible and a lot higher end than what the retail price would suggest. And I've been really, really happy with it so far. I've only got a handful of rides, but I'll be doing a full review on this frame set. Now they have updated it since this frame. They're now doing internal cable routing through the headset, which I'm not a huge fan of, but the look is a little different. So if you're looking for this frame secondhand, you can still find them pretty easily, but the new ones are going to be updated. And if I do a full review, I'll make sure to compare if there's any geometry differences, because I think there might be. But that being said, I built this thing up and it's got all the modern things that most road bikes have. It'll clear up to a 32, no problem. I've snuck in a set of 35s on here, a little close for comfort, but did ride those for a little bit. And it's crazy getting back onto a standard road bike, let's call it. But the reason why I'm making this video is to say, hey, I've been totally a believer in carbon and steel ride quality. I haven't ridden titanium yet, so I can't speak to that. But a modern day aluminum bike, it actually is a lot better than it used to be. Like a lot of people say that you've probably seen videos of. I haven't ridden an aluminum bike in probably 10 years, and this is drastically different. Now, the big thing I would tell people is if you're going to go this route, putting a set of wheels on this will make it substantially lighter and ride better than the carbon variant with the heavier aluminum wheels on it. But tires are really going to make a difference as well. These Vittoria courses, I don't recommend for most people because they're so light and brittle, but they've been fine so far for me. I don't know they're not going to last long. They were just a gift and they ride amazingly. A good set of supple tires is really going to improve your ride quality, especially if you're riding an aluminum frame of varying brands. And we're going to do one thing for ride quality. These things, like I said, really ride really, really well. And obviously a carbon set of wheels like the carbon frame set will dampen some more vibrations before it gets to you. That being said, I want to weigh this thing because I just finished building it and it currently does have my SPD Bontrager pedals on there because they do look primo on here, but they are about 200 grams heavier than my Speed Plays. But that being said, let me do a quick breakdown of all the parts that are on here and put a comment below if you think this is heavier or lighter at the end than what you expected. So that being said, I'm 5'11". I ride a 56 ALR, obviously again, custom painted. I have maxed out with a custom painted stem. We have a AliExpress special weight weenie expander plug in here and a top cap, as well as a set of carbon whiskey bars in the 6-degree flare paired with a set of Rival Access electronic shifters for the seat post. This is the stock one I got off my Cobalt Marauder, had it forever. A Specialized Torx 155 full carbon saddle, which is my go-to favorite. Cages are a set of Specialized carbon cages with their tool mount on there. Crankset is a Force 1 crankset with a Garborg 42 tooth chainring with a KMC X12 chain. Rear derailleur is a Apex Explorer with AliExpress oversized gold jockey wheels for the look, mainly to be honest. Current cassette that's on here is a 1044 Explorer Force level cassette. The wheels, which if you want to see more specs on these, are custom set of white bicycle wheels I just built. I'll put a card above so you can watch the full spec on these. But big hitter, they're a little over 1100 grams and cost me just a tad over $900 shipped. Wrapped in Vittoria Corsa Pros in a 32 width setup tubeless. And the rotors are an older set of Dura-Ace 160 rotors front and rear. So that being said, let's weigh this. And as you can see here, this is the total weight at 17.3 pounds. And now I'm super excited to say that's really, really good. Because like I was saying, this is functional weight. That includes my little light bracket, both bottle cages, the tool holder, my heavier set of pedals, my front mount, my bell, everything I normally ride with, just minus the lights and the saddlebag and my computer. So that being said, this probably actually with the Speed Plays sits around 17.1 and without anything on it bare as Trek would weigh their bikes or any other brand realistically. This thing I would assume is going to sit right at 16.1, 16.3. I want to go for a ride right now, so I'm not going to strip it down because I got everything all just set up. But if you want to see that, comment below and follow me on Instagram and I'll post a final weight bare and we'll see who's correct. This has been a really fun build. I really do enjoy this bike. I don't know how long I'm going to keep it. The frame set I might sell to rebuild an older bike just for more tire clearance, let's say. But I want to experiment of what it's like to be back on a regular road bike and try to get back into shape because I'm working remote and get training rides and things like that. And I'll probably make some vlogs and stuff like that on this video. But if you have any questions as a newer road cyclist or someone maybe looking for a new bike, comment below and let's talk about maybe bring back the aluminum bikes. I don't know. You let me know. So that being said, thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe, turn notifications on so you can watch the next videos because we're back, baby, and we're making videos every single week or streaming or maybe both. Who knows? But thanks for watching this episode of Locked In. Let's get locked in.